No, don't tell him that.
This is our problem, let's have a bit of that.
Quiet, please.
Let's have a bit of that. Let's have a bit of that.
Big bro on the drum.
Yeah, walking on the park. There's a seaside resort they call Blackpool, which is noted for fresh air and fun. And Mr. and Mrs. Ramsbottom were there with young Albert, their son. He a grand little lad with young Albert, and his best looked as swell, with a stick with an horse's head handle, the best one that Woolworths could sell. They didn't think much of the ocean. The waves was all sibling and small. No shipwrecks and no one was drowning. That not to laugh at it all. So seeking further amusement, the pair went into a zoo. There were lions and tigers and camels, and all whales with sandwiches too. There was one great big lion called Wallace, and his face was all covered with scars, and he lay in a somnolent posture with his head close up to the bars. And Albert had heard about lions as how they was ferocious and wild, and seeing one lion so peaceful didn't seem right to the child. So straightway the brave little fella, without showing a morsel of fear, took the stick with the horse's head handle and poked it in Wallace's ear. He could see that the lion didn't like it, and given a kind of a roar, pulled out at the cage and swallowed it with that hole. Her father had seen the occurrence and didn't know what to do next. He said, "Hey mother, your lion's at Albert." Mother said, "Here I am vexed." The keeper he had to be sent for, he comes and says, "Hey, what's to do?" Father says, "Young lion's at Albert, and even the son did best do." The manager wanted no trouble, and he pulled out his purse right away. And he says, "How much to settle the matter?" Father says, "What do you
mean?" "Yeah, what he said."
At that mark, I got right red and angry when she thought where our poor son had gone. "No! Someone has got to be summoned for this." So that was decided upon. So they went straightway up to the police station, up before the magistrate chap. And they told they had a lion at Albert, and to prove it they showed him his cap. The magistrate heard the full story. He says, "No one was really to blame. And he hoped that Mr. and Mrs. Ramsbottom would have many more summons to their name." At that mile I got right red and blazing. Until the magistrate said to him, "What? Spend all our lives raising children to feed bloody lions? Not me." But I've left it at that now, but I'm sorry, isn't it?
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. And we wish you a Merry Christmas.
Down to earth.
was to set and worship the things fields as they came. In fields where they praised people their sheep, or the coverings as night and waters as deep. No way, no way.
When the snow lay round about, deep and crisp and even, brightly shone the moonlight night, though the frost was cruel. When the poor men came in sight, gathering winds of funeral. Men left his chance stand by me, if thou wouldst tell me. Yonder peasant, who is he? Where and what is dwelling? Sighing is a goodly glimpse underneath the mountain, right against the forest gates, or some Agnes fountain.
Hark the herald at Lessing,
Hark the glory to the newborn King. He's on earth and the sea wild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations round, for a triumph of the sun. Glory to the host proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Holy night, all is round, all is right.
Just turn the guitar about, mate.